President William Ruto has fired all cabinet secretaries and the Attorney General with immediate effect. Addressing the nation from State House, Nairobi, Thursday afternoon, President Ruto said the only office that will not be affected is that of the Deputy President and Prime Cabinet Secretary. President Ruto said he had resolved to dissolve his cabinet upon reflection and listening keenly to the people of Kenya.
I have today, in line with the powers given to me by Article 1521 and 1525B of the Constitution and Sections 12 of the Office of the Attorney General's Act, decided to dismiss with immediate effect all the Cabinet Secretaries and Attorney General of the Republic of Kenya, of the Cabinet of Kenya, except the Prime Cabinet Secretary and Cabinet Secretary for Secretary and Cabinet Secretary for Foreign Affairs and Diaspora Affairs. And of course, the office of the Deputy President is not affected in any way.
Kenyan President William Ruto on Friday proposed spending cuts and additional borrowing in roughly equal measures to fill a nearly $2.7 billion budget hole caused by his withdrawal of planned tax hikes in the face of nationwide protests. Ruto scrapped the finance bill containing the tax increase in response to mass youth-led demonstrations that have created the biggest crisis in his two-year-old presidency. Police have today cleared the national platform to resume their nationwide mobilization tours. The NUP tours were halted following the fatal accident that occurred on Masaka Road involving their procession as they proceeded to hold a rally in Masaka. However, today, the NUP spokesperson and leader of opposition, Joel Senyonyi, led a delegation of party officials to the police headquarters in Naguru seeking police clearance for the tours. During the meeting, which journalists were barred from covering, the police agreed the request, but with some conditions. NUP leaders later briefed journalists about the developments but expressed concern over the conditions.
So we honored a meeting at the police headquarters. They did invite us for a meeting after we wrote, notifying them about our next phase of the countrywide tour. You remember we were meant to start this very week, but when they wrote asking us to meet them on Thursday, we said no problem, we can pause a little bit, meet with them, engage, and we establish what concerns there are and so on. That meeting has happened, and on our end, we want to keep showing that we are civil.
Beginning our activities in Bundibugyo on Monday, and we shall do the western stretch as you know it. So, want to encourage and invite our people in Bundibugyo not to be afraid, because one of the things we raised actually, which the Deputy President Western, and we've seen this everywhere. Even venue owners fear to give us venues because they say first give us clearance from the police.
Next week, the party will hold a rally in Chenjojo. The Buganda Road Chief Magistrate's Court has dismissed the charges of obtaining money by false pretense which had been leveled against David Balondem, the Kampala District Land Board boss. The prosecution alleged that Balondem and others still at large between November 2022 and April 2023 at Bloom Advocates located at Kingdom Building in Kampala with intent to defraud, obtained $553,000, about 2.2 billion shillings, from KG Unlimited LLC. The presiding Grade 1 magistrate, Winnie Nancha, dismissed the case today on grounds that the prosecution has failed to produce witnesses to testify in the matter. The magistrate said the matter has been in court since September last year and prosecution has been given several adjournments to produce witnesses but in vain. After the dismissal of the case, defense lawyer Hassan Kamba welcomed the court decision, saying justice had been served.
The matter has been dismissed. You saw how these people were arrested by Shaku and how they were paraded in the new vision. Even the case was voted the criminal case of the year in the December New Vision newspapers. Now the case has ended, no witness has been brought. Our client is now clean. Not commit an offense, and the court has agreed with us that indeed the trial is turning into a mistrial and the case has been dismissed under section 119 of the MCA.
Balondemo has been battling the charges alongside Ronald Chizito Kaweesa alias Dennis Tumusiime, Geoffrey Eric Mukwe, and Joseph Ibona.